Have you ever been so excited that no matter how hard you try, you just can't sleep due to sheer adrenaline-induced excitement?
No.
Well, I was going to say...
I've never been to Disneyland.
I was going to say, that sums up my night last night, because, you know, today Oculus Rift is in the building. Something to get excited about.
It's only because I forgot yesterday. Had I remembered, I'd have been lying there.
Oculus Rift.
But why?
Oculus is here.
Why
Oculus,
are you so excited? Oculus. Why am I so excited? Why is everyone so excited?
It's virtual reality. Virtual reality is one of the biggest buzzwords at the moment, and largely in part down to Oculus Rift. You know, it's an amazing virtual reality headset that's going to completely revolutionise the way we game. It's going to revolutionise all these interactive experiences and get us to experience things like we've never experienced before in glorious virtual reality.
There's so many things that potentially we could do. What are people doing it right now?
Well, obviously, of course, first and foremost, gaming is quite a big deal. I had a go with it back in January, so I played Eve Valkyrie. What we've got going on at the back here, we've got a Red Bull Air Race kind of interactive virtual experience. It's pretty much a carbon copy of the race at Ascot, which is pretty cool. We've got Chris donning the Oculus Rift headset there.
It's going to take his earphone so he actually hear us, but it's fine. Can you hear us, Chris?
I can hear you. You're very quiet, though.
We have to shout.
You sound like you're in the plane with me a little bit.
I'm gonna
try this demo standing up. This is an incredibly bad idea.
Chris is in a plane now. Chris is pretending to be in a plane.
Yes. Okay. So this is, you know, back to what I was saying. So obviously, gaming is quite a big deal. Now, I had a go back in January. I played Eve Valkyrie. So, you know, I've got my Xbox controller in my hand. I'm targeting enemies with my head. And it's just a really natural way to play gaming. And what's so great about this device is that it can basically track your movement, not only where you're looking, but it's got positional tracking as well.
The tracking is very good, I've got to say.
You can look around corners. What was that? It's very good.
Oh, I'm off. Oh. Yeah, it's very low latency. There's like almost no latency at all, actually. Very little screen tear.
No one asked him.
Whoa.
Thanks, Chris.
But
cheers.
He makes a really valid point. So back in 2012, this was announced as a Kickstarter project, probably one of the most successful Kickstarter projects to date. You know, they made a lot of money, more money than they ever thought they would get for it. And initially, you know, it induced a lot of motion sickness, a lot of latency, a disorientation, dizziness. You know, a lot of people criticised it for that. But, you know, Oculus went back to the drawing board, slapped a 1080p screen in it, everything looked a lot better. And then they announced another model, which was the DK2 Crystal Cove device, which full of infrared LEDs that work in unison with an infrared camera and basically tracks you better than ever before. That's when positional head tracking
right now, it's not a commercial thing in the sense of like, you and I can't just go into PC World or Currys or whatever and buy one and then
sadly
strap ourselves at home and go.
No, it's developer. It's in developer territory at the moment.
Any second.
It looks like he's about to fall over.
Okay, no, I'm okay now. We're leveled out again.
He's leveled out. Are we allowed to carry on talking now? Is that all right?
Wait, what was that?
Right, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, that's fantastic, actually.
So we've got Chris standing up.
Oh, this is right, I didn't realise this is actually what he's doing now.
He's flying a plane.
I knew what he was doing, but I didn't realise that it was behind us as well. But anyway.
Interesting we've got Chris standing up because this is going to be something that's mainly based as a sitting down product, so you're playing games or, you know,
this was definitely a sitting down product.
So how are you feeling after that? Obviously that was a simulation of the Red Bull Air Race in Ascot, so it's pretty, you know, it's supposed to be replicating those high G's, spinning around, doing the corkscrews and stuff like that. Did you feel it? Did it feel like you're actually there?
It's very, very, it's immersive. Yeah. What tends to happen is as you do like the big manoeuvres.
Come and join us on the sofa.
I'm gonna keep this on though, because I like it.
Because you look cool.
I feel like some kind of futuristic exterminator of some kind. When you do the big manoeuvres and things like that, there's no G-forces, there's no actual movement going on, but your body kind of like half replaces them. Mm. It's a very strange sensation.
So how did that barrel drop or roll or whatever it's called, how did that feel?
Well, a double barrel roll, I imagine, whilst not as bad as real life, was a little bit stomach turning.
Yeah, I've actually tried it in real life.
I think,
and I vomed violently.
Yeah.
So at least, so I didn't. It's not that real.
So as you can see, I didn't vom, which is good. But it did make me feel a little bit queasy.
But it's kind of exciting, though, the fact
but
that...
But that's what a double barrel roll will do.
But that was passive, though. You were sitting there just experiencing, you were just watching.
Yeah.
You move your head around. And the one I did was like that as well. So I'm really excited for the idea of playing, apparently, like Alien Isolation, quite a few big releases that come out recently. There are Rift versions of it that you can actually play. And for me, that would be incredible. Like, one that sounds incredible is my friend told me there's one where you basically sit there and scary things happen around you. And the whole object of the game is literally just to sit as still as possible. And so if you move, if you move, you lose. And it would just be things going up like, into your face. You just go
trying
like,
your best not to jump.
Like things like that. Like, you know, it's really interesting, isn't it?
That sounds quite cool. Well,
I can handle
it, with
it as long as it wasn't you doing that.
Yeah.
I'd be okay.
You can handle like that Aphex Twin video though. comes up, but me, nah.
Yeah, but it was genuinely very, very good.
And was that your first time?
That was my first experience.
Oh, you're no longer a Rift virgin.
Crazy.
Popped your cherry.
That was my first time, and it was a good first time. I don't regret it. I would do it again. I'm considering buying one.
I was going to say, do we know when they are going to be, I look at you as the fountain of the knowledge, do we know when they're going to be sort of commercially available?
We do not know, actually. They've recently announced another developer model called Crescent Bay. So they were, again, just introducing a whole new level of intricate sensors. It's able to kind of track you a lot better than the Crystal Co version. It's got the LED infrareds at the back as well as at the front. So just a lot more of an immersive experience. So they're getting better. And you think you'll attest to this, you know, at this stage, it's unbelievable. So imagine when it finally gets to the consumer level, what kind of...
I mean, the technology is great already. I mean, obviously it suffers for... There aren't many games that support it at the moment. There are ones coming out, like Eve Valkyrie, which is sort of a space flight kind of game, which is perfect for this
you
kind of
product. You said that's the one you said you had a go.
Well, like, that was just a demo that was set up to use alongside this stage. Kind of you're not sure what's going to be compatible with it. You know, it's got HDMI and USB, which ultimately means it is compatible with a lot of devices. It's just whether those manufacturers are going to enable it
Facebook brought it, is that?
Yeah, Facebook
so,
brought it.
So we can all look forward to some virtual pokes going on. I don't know what that would mean, but like, you know.
I think you might be talking about a different side to the product.
Does anyone even poke anymore? Maybe this will be the resurgence of poking. That's what it's here for.
Yeah, perhaps, you know, perhaps a different type of poking.
What we can take from this is virtual reality is the next best thing. You've got Project Morpheus, you've got Samsung's Gear VR, you've got loads of things like this, kind of mobile virtual reality.
It's exciting.
Yeah,
You know, it's every geek stream, I think, or video gaming geek stream is the full immersion thing.
Tell you what, it shits all over a virtual boy, that's for sure.
Yes.
In the table.
And on that note, we'd love to hear what you think. Yeah. Are you a fan of Oculus Swift? Are you waiting for the next best thing in gaming and kind of interactive experiences? Or do you want something that's a bit more affordable and budget, like something like this? We'd love to hear in the comments below. And of course, subscribe, tell your friends, comment, and come back and see us.
Sure.